Okay friends, so in the previous video we just introduced the tooth and what are the parts, what are the morphological, the macro parts of the tooth, and then we discussed the crown, and then we discussed the the enamel. In this lecture we are discussing the dentine part of the tooth, which is the part of the tooth below the enamel. So as we know, every teeth has these three parts: the crown, the neck and the root. So in the previous lecture we discussed about the enamel. What is enamel? I'm writing it again. What is enamel? It is the hardest part of the tooth. It is the exposed shiny part of tooth. Yes, it is 92% composed of inorganic substances. And what are these inorganic substances? These inorganic substances are calcium carbonate, calcium phosphate, and calcium hydroxide. And combinedly they make a mass which is called hydroxyapatite. Yes. The mass, this mass of this hydroxyapatite, or the whole mass of the enamel, is secreted by two types of cells. These are called ameloblasts and enameloblast cells. Okay. These two types of cells are secreting the whole mass of the enamel, right? So next we said that this enamel is avascular. Enamel is avascular, and the last point that we had clear is enamel is hard to decay. These points are clear about enamel, right? Let's bring our camera here. This was the part of the tooth which is called enamel. And about the enamel, we know those points. The part of the tooth which is below the enamel, this part which extends down to the root and surrounds the pulp of the tooth, this part of the tooth is called the dentine of the tooth. Yes. What is dentine? Dentine is the part of the tooth which lies next to enamel, and it goes down towards the root and surrounds the pulp of the tooth. Yes, let's discuss about the dentine. This was first. Next, dentine. What is dentine? Dentine is part of the tooth below the enamel. Yes. The type of cells which are present in enamel are ameloblasts and enameloblasts. And here the cells which are present are called odontoblast cells. Or we can say the mass of dentine is secreted by odontoblast cells. What is dentine is composed of? Dentine is composed of 62% to 68% it is inorganic in nature. 62 to 68%, it is inorganic in nature. Yes. Dentine is 62 to 68% inorganic in nature, and dentine is highly calcified. Dentine is highly calcified in nature. Now, other than this, we can see that dentine has spiral shaped openings towards the enamel. Yes, dentine has spiral shaped openings which are moving towards the enamel. So this was the second part of the tooth. What was the first part? That was enamel, we just discussed. Then we have dentine. So what is the important point? The important points are, which type of cells are secreting enamel? These are ameloblasts and enamelloblasts. Which type of cells are secreting the dentine mass of the tooth? Those group of cells are called odontoblasts. So what is dentine? This is very brief about dentine. The next part of the tooth, that is the third part, that is pulp. The third part of the tooth is called pulp. Let's bring our camera here. This part is called, this connective tissue mass which is present here, this is the third part of the tooth, and this part is called the pulp of the tooth. This part is called the pulp of the tooth. Okay friends, this pulp is in, if we consider in this tooth, the pulp is closed. It is a closed tube. It is a closed tube in which, inside which arteries, veins and narrows are moving up towards the upper parts of the tooth. So this is a closed mass of, what is pulp? Pulp is a closed mass of connective tissue. What is pulp? It is a mass of loose fibrous connective tissue. What is pulp? It is a mass of, pulp is a mass of loose fibrous connective tissue. Yes. What is pulp? Pulp is a loose mass of, it is a mass of loose fibrous connective tissue. The type of cells which are secreting the mass of the pulp are also called odontoblast cells. The cells which are present in the pulp, in the walls of the pulp, these cells are also known as odontoblasts. What does the pulp contain? The pulp contains vessels and nerves. The pulp contain vessels and nerves. And the cells which are present are columnar shaped. The cells are columnar shaped cells. These cells are present, if I make the pulp here, if this is our pulp going up, and this is our the pulp of the tooth, so the cells which are present here are columnar shaped cells. The cells which are present here are the columnar shaped cells, and these cells are called odontoblasts. Actually these are epithelial cells. So these cells are responsible, they are columnar shaped cells, and these cells are responsible for secreting the mass of the pulp. These cells secrete the mass of the pulp. Yes, these are the three main parts of the tooth. What are these? The first one is enamel, the second one is dentine, and the third one is the pulp of the tooth. The important points, again, important points are, the pulp of the tooth contains blood vessels and nerves moving up. Let's bring the camera here. Look here. These are the nerves and the blood vessels which are moving up. The arteries and nerves moving up and the veins coming down in the pulp or the tube or the mass of the fibrous connective tissue. So this was the third part. Now keeping the camera here, we can say about the fourth part of the tooth. What is that? Here, yes, here we have the fourth part of the tooth. In this part helps the teeth to be hardly embedded inside the bony socket. Or it is a mass which connects the tooth to the periodontal ligament. And this mass is known as cementum. Cementum is the part of the tooth. Cementum is a mass of connective tissue which surrounds the lower parts of dentine. So the fourth thing, that is cementum. What is cementum? Cementum is composed of a chemical substance which is called hyaluronic acid. Cementum is composed of hyaluronic acid and it attaches the tooth firmly
to periodontal ligament. Cementum works as cement, as an holding object. Cementum holds the tooth in its socket. Yes, this was the fourth part of the tooth here. And the next part and the last part that we have is periodontal ligament. Yes, friends, this ligament surrounds the root of the tooth. And what is its function and what is periodontal ligament? It is a type of dense regular fibrous connective tissue. And the joint of the tooth with its socket is made by, is held by this ligament, and this ligament is called periodontal ligament, and the joint between this periodontal ligament and the teeth socket is called gomposis. Yes, so here is our bony socket for the tooth. This is the bone, either maxilla or mandible. So this is our bone. Now look here. This tooth is joined by periodontal ligament. This blue color is our periodontal ligament. So this periodontal ligament is, what is this? It is a connective tissue. It connects the tooth to the bone. So this joint is called gomposis. So the fifth part is, what is that? The fifth part is periodontal ligament. What is this? Periodontal ligament is a dense regular fibrous connective tissue. It surrounds the lower part, or it surrounds the root of the
tooth and what is its function? It holds the tooth. It holds the tooth. Holds the tooth. It holds the tooth. And the next function, it makes gomposis. It makes the gomposis joint. Okay, friends. So these were our four parts. Now let's put all these parts in this diagram. So we will see, we will clear all parts of the tooth. Right. Here is the pulp. This is the pulp. Inside the pulp, artery is going up. Inside the pulp, arterial system is going up. And venous system is coming down. Inside the pulp, arterial system is going up and venous system is coming back, right? From here, nerves also going up. Okay, this is our pulp. So above the pulp, around the pulp, we have, what was that? Around the pulp, we have dentine. Around the pulp, we have our dentine. Okay. Let's bring it little down. This is our dentine. Around the pulp, we have the second part of the tooth. That is dentine. So this is dentine. This is dentine, and around the dentine here we have, what was this part? This was enamel. This is enamel, and here we have our, these are our gums. These are gums. Okay. Okay, friends. These are the parts of the tooth. So in this lecture, we just discussed the parts of the tooth. In the next lecture, we will be, inshallah, discussing the types of the tooth on the basis of morphology and the basis of structures and the basis of development. So this was all about the parts of the teeth. So if you, friends, if you like the video, so please subscribe the channel. Please write some comments. That we can develop our lectures more according to your choices. Thank you so much.